Now students, here we are going to have an electric equipotential surface of various charge system. Now what is various charge system? If we are having only a positive charge system, what will happen with the equipotential surface? Second thing is, if we are having two oppositely charged system, means one is positive and negative, what will happen? We will go with the positive. Positive means same charges, two equal positive charges, and the for a uniform electric field. So if we go to this first positive charge system, in this you will see this is a positive charge and the electric field lines which are coming like this, they are radially outward in all direction. Now we know that V is equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q upon R. R is the distance between the charge and the point where we want to know the electric potential. जहाँ पे हमको electric potential define करना है, उस point से, उस positive charge से वो point का distance, that is inversely proportional. यहाँ पे inversely proportional है. Means if we move in this all direction, we are having equipotential surfaces. If we move away from this, again we are having this surface. Means from in all direction, if we are moving away from the same distance, we will be having same electric potential. If we are taking this as a R, it is going to be the electric potential which we are going to have. It is here, if we move this with same distance in all direction, in all direction, the equipotential is going to be the same. So equipotential surface for a positive charge where electric field lines are coming out in all direction, what we are getting, the electric potential is the same. Means we can say it is spherically or in sim. Here what we are getting, a circle of radius r, or a sphere of radius r. This is radius r. Okay, so this way the electric potential at every point, it is going to be same, that is equipotential surface. Again, if we are moving away from this point with the same distance in all direction, we are getting an equipotential surface. Okay, so this is the positive charge system. We found that the equipotential surface all around from this point, means from this charge, positive charge, is equal. Again, it is equal. No, not necessarily this point, you can have here also. So this way, positive charge system, here what we are getting, equipotential surface, which is going to be. Now if we go with this, we know that electric field also, minus dV by dr. So if R is changing, R is changing, electric dV is constant throughout this surface, R is also same. So electric field which we are getting in this direction will be given by this relation also. Now if we go with the another point, two positive oppositely charged system, one is positive charge system and another one is negative charge system. So electric field lines which are coming out and terminating here, they are coming out radially outward from positive charge and negative charge. So here what we are getting, a stronger electric field. And according to that, if a stronger electric field is there, if we go with this, what we are getting, E is equal to dV by dr. This is strong electric field, means the distance is lesser. Equipotential surface in terms of this, here what we are going to have, an equipotential surface near to it. It can be a dipole. It can be a dipole with a very small distance, means it is separated by a very small distance. And when it is separated by a very small distance, we are getting the equipotential surface here. Okay. Similarly, if we go in this two equal positive charge, If you see here, the electric field lines which are coming out in this direction, in all direction. And when we go through this electric field lines, you'll see this is a weaker electric field, weaker region. The electric, there is a repulsion, or there is a, here it is a stronger one, here it is a weaker one. So they are having a distance. Equipotential surface is also separated. They will have some distance. Okay. Now if we go through the next point, these for a uniform electric field. Now if we go through this, these are the equipotential surfaces. These are the equipotential surfaces which are parallel to each other. Equipotential surfaces, they are parallel to each other. Now when they are parallel to each other, means they are having a equally space distance. Now we know that if we talk about the electric field which are coming out in this direction, means it is perpendicular to this direction, this is having a 90 degree angle. So they are normal to the electric field which is normal to the equipotential surface. This is also equipotential surface. And if you go through this equipotential surface, electric field, we can take this as an electric field. Okay. Now electric field which we can define here, it is dV by dr. Now if we take this point, electric field in this direction, if we move, it is if we move in this direction and if we move in this direction, what will happen? It is opposite to this, that is 180 degree. Here if we are taking electric field in this direction, say if we are talking about this direction, so electric field is, and electric potential will have a relationship, and that will be, if we go through this, dV E dot dr, E dot dr now if it is having a zero angle, electric potential is going to decrease in this direction as we move away from this. Okay, now if we are taking this again, we are having an angle theta which is equals to 90 degree, cos 90, that is going to be zero. So in this direction, if electric field is there, the surface is like this, equipotential surface is, that is equipotential surface. Again we move in this direction, that is 180, which is going to be the, again electric field is going to decrease. So if we are having a positive charge, and here it is, if we are having an equipotential surface, means the potential is same throughout this, the equipotential surface will be always normal to it, will be always normal to it. Okay, so here equipotential surfaces of various charge system, we have gone through this. Equipotential surfaces for positive charge system, to oppositely charge system, to equal positively charged system, and the equipotential surface which are parallel to each other, and the electric field will be in the direction perpendicular to the direction of a perpendicular to the equipotential surfaces. Okay. Now see here, from this we can conclude here that the electric potential, if we go through this, electric potential and electrostatic potential which is having equipotential surfaces, means equipotential surfaces are there, and we are having a relationship between equipotential surface and electric field. Now if we go through this, now the equipotential surface, if we talk about this, equipotential surface are this, and if we see this is having electric field is having the direction which is perpendicular to it, or we can say which is normal to it. Okay, similarly if we go with this, what we are getting, they are very strong. Electric field lines are very strong and equipotential surfaces are very close to each other. But as we move in the weaker field region, here it is a weaker field region, they are getting apart, the equipotential surfaces are getting apart, means the distance is increasing. So equipotential surfaces and the electric field and its direction, which we can understand by this relation, by these systems, where positively charged system is giving this in two positively oppositely charged, where they are getting attracted here, where is a strong electric field and the equipotential surfaces are very close to each other. In this case, they are getting separated, means there is a repulsion because we are having two equal positively charged. Now if we go through this, what we are getting, the electric field are a weaker one, they are here weaker one, and the equipotential surfaces are getting separated, they are having a space. Here it is, equipotential surface we have taken like this, they are parallel to each other, and the electric, if we talk about the direction and the magnitude, the direction will be perpendicular to it, means normal to the surface. Okay. So we can conclude here our lecture with this.